Hello, if you are at any leadership position in an organization, you can contribute a lot to make that organization a happy and a healthy workplace. What is it that you can do at that level to make this possible? So in this video, I'm going to share with you some ideas which will help you to contribute towards making your workplace a happy and healthy workplace. So let us begin. The first thought that I'm sharing is strengthen manager-employee relationships. Now, let us ask ourselves, why are relations important in any organization? In fact, if you look at it closely, you will notice without relations, nothing works. Relations are the essence of working of an organization. Organization means a set of people, and if they have to be together, obviously their relations need to be right, so that the frictions are reduced and operations run smoothly. When you have great relations, decisions are taken faster, executions are seamless, and that is how it helps the organization. And obviously, when the relations are powerful, people will feel happy, people will feel connected. Now, that is why you need to pay extra attention towards making the relations of managers and employees that they are leading meaningful. You need to work on strengthening those relations, and whatever it requires to be done for making it possible must be taken as an initiative. Whether some efforts are required for the managers, whether some efforts are required for employees, work towards that. That'll help a lot. Second important thing is embrace feedback. Now, what do I mean by this is that in many places, in many behaviors, when feedback is given, people tend to become defensive. People take it negatively, whereas behavior improves only when you receive the feedback and work on it. That is why any feedback that comes to you, you need to embrace it. So notice the word that I'm using. I'm saying embrace it. I'm not saying accept it. After you receive the feedback, you can mull over it, you can have a reflection on that, and then take an appropriate action. That's perfectly fine. But first step that is required is embrace feedback. Third important thing that needs to be done to make happy and healthy workplaces is give your team trust and support. Any team will perform much, much better if they have the trust of the people working together and the support from the people who are leading them. Obviously, this is something which is the essence of working of a team, that there is trust and support in the working together. So if you have to provide that, if you are a person who is going to influence the flow of trust and support amongst team members, take those initiatives. And what is essentially required to develop trust within team members is that people are accountable, people are walking the talk, people are living up to their promises, people are open to communicate, right? So that is what is a sign of trust. And support is something people know, that I have the back of someone else, and that's how they keep on moving ahead. They keep on taking decisions, they keep on taking initiatives. Next important thing is, again, very significant, prioritize work-life integration. I always put it like this: work is an integral part of life which consumes a lot of time on a day-to-day basis. But when it comes to integrating it with the whole life, that's something very important. If you are working in an organization, it does not stop that people come, work, take the pay, and after that they are left to themselves. Since they are contributing to your organization, it becomes imperative on you as a leader that you are taking note of how is it influencing their total life. Holistic view of life is important for leaders in any organization. So work towards creating work-life integration for people that is positively going to influence to make your organization a happy and a healthy workplace. Next important thought that I'm sharing is praise and recognize often. I have always been an advocate of saying that if any organization is progressing, it is because of people. It is not because of the leader that any organization is moving ahead. It is because of the collective efforts of people. And that is what needs to be recognized. That is what needs to be appreciated. And if you do it quite frequently, obviously, it will change the energy of the whole organization. And you're not doing it for the purpose of making people happy. You're not doing it with that intention. You are very genuine in praising people. You are very genuine in recognizing them for the efforts that they are putting in. And the last thought that I'm sharing is, again, something which I like a lot, I cherish a lot, I keep on talking about it. Make work meaningful. And the way to look at it is, if your organization is in existence, if your organization is creating some products or services, obviously they are solving some problem somewhere. Isn't it? That's the way I look at it. And when any problem is being solved, anything is being made simpler, the credit goes to whom? Credit goes to people who are making it possible. But the question is whether people are treating that as just a job, or whether people are treating it as something bigger, as a contribution to the world at large. As that thought process shifts, it makes a huge change in the way they'll start looking at their work. They start treating it as meaningful, and when any work is treated as meaningful, there's a higher level of fulfillment and there is much higher level of commitment. So all these 6 points put into action are definitely going to contribute your workplace a happy and a healthy workplace. I'll keep on sharing more thoughts in my upcoming videos. Wish you all the best.